Hey y'all, cleaned it up a little bit. Thought you might want to get a better look at it. Look at all the prints in it. How cool is that? I'm trying to get a ride right now. I don't want to walk 4 miles with this. I'm glad I at least brought some dry shoes, man. I'm freezing right now. I think I got another big chunk of that blue stuff. Look at this. Oh my goodness. Look at this, y'all. Looky here. That looks like a big old chunk in there. Look at this, y'all. Oh my goodness. Oh man, there's still massive amounts of this stuff down here. I didn't know. Yeah, I'm willing to bet this is not epoxy or man-made stuff. This is Mayan blue clay, I think, y'all. I thought I gathered it all up, but it just keeps coming out of the bank. And for that reason, I'm gonna go ahead and declare it is not man-made. And you can see the deposits in the bank. Hey y'all, so it is many months later, and I want to give y'all a look at what came of this stuff that a lot of people were suggesting was Mayan blue clay that I was finding in the creek. It's basically turning into like a blue chalk right now. Breaks apart pretty easy. Looks like blue chalk. But when I uploaded the original video called I Found a Motherload of Blue Gold, I started finding little pieces of this in the creek. And gradually, as I went upstream, I was finding bigger pieces, and I found the chunk up or 3 foot long with the animal prints in it. I walked 3 or 4 miles home with this because I couldn't find a ride. I wasn't mobile at the time. And when I was looking at it the next day, I started never looking at it and it fell apart. I still got that piece though. But a lot of people were suggesting when I uploaded the original video that it was Mayan blue clay when I uploaded pictures of stuff on my Facebook Relic Hunting Club. A lot of people were suggesting Mayan blue clay. Apparently, specialists had done tests in the past on Mayan blue paint in South America and detected Georgia blue clay in the paint. So I don't know. If you watch the original video, you will see there is what looks like veins of blue clay in the bank. So a lot of people were suggesting it was epoxy or swimming pool paint or something like that. But this is a really mineral-rich area. This is where I found the clay point, my nicest flint arrowhead that I'm giving away in the giveaway. I found it in the Sand Creek in the within yards of this stuff. It's also where I found the selenite that I sent 365 Headhunter. This is a really mineral-rich area, y'all. I really don't know what this stuff is, man, but I want to take it to a geologist. And when I wasn't mobile, Sam, when I get mobile again, I'm going to take the stuff to a geologist and have him look at it. But it's something I do plan on doing, you know. Maybe it is some kind of blue chalk or something. I don't know. But that would be really cool if it did turn out to be Mayan blue clay. So I'm going to try to contact the local geologist at one of the local colleges and give them some samples, see if they'll look at it, you know. And what I planned on doing today was taking, you know, some of y'all might have seen the video where I found this, what I think is a blue gemstone in the creek last weekend with my nephews. I plan on taking it to somebody today and have them look at it, a place called Prospector's Pouch in Kennesaw, Georgia, around Ackworth, where I'm from. But what I called ahead, they said it was a $25 fee for them to do that, you know, to do tests on it and stuff. So I didn't have that, so I wasn't able to do that today. Maybe next weekend I'll be able to do that. That'd be cool if that turned out to be blue sapphire. I don't know a whole lot about gemstones. I have found a handful of gemstones in the past from the same creek. Red looking rubies, turquoise and stuff. I had a whole handful of them. When I lost them when I moved, I had them wrapped up in a paper towel. And I think I accidentally threw them away, unfortunately. Which sucks. If that turned out blue sapphire, that'd be super cool. You know, it might not be a gemstone at all. I don't know. And also, y'all, I made a video of this. This is what I found in the river kayaking and fishing a few weeks ago. And I thought I lost it. I made a video of it and said I lost it, unfortunately, on the riverbank. But no, it was in the bottom of my bucket. It just slid down beneath the tackle. But I don't know if this is a fossil or not, just a stone. But given the curve in it, I was like, that's why I was so curious about it. Is it a piece of a tusk or something? I have no idea, you know. I'm new to the fossil game, y'all. But I don't know. What do y'all think? How do you tell? I mean, look at the bottom of it. Almost like flint, you know what I mean? What does it turn into? Is it petrified wood? You know,
given the curve in it, I thought it might be a piece of a tusk or something. I thought it was a bison horn at first, but people told me, you know, horns would be hollow. So I don't know, y'all. But I've asked people's opinions on this, and here's a better look at it. If y'all can give me your opinion on it and let me know what you think it is. I don't want this video to be super long, so yeah, here's the stuff. Y'all, this is what it turned into, what I thought was Mayan blue clay. I don't know what it is. Hopefully we'll get it looked at soon and get a definitive answer on it, along with this other stuff. I appreciate y'all watching. Hoping you're having a good weekend. Have a blessed week. Good luck and happy hunting. Love y'all.
Day after day, I'm more confused. Yet I look for the light through the pouring rain. You know that's a game that I hate to lose. And I'm feeling the strain. Ain't it a shame? Oh, give me the beat, boys, and free my soul.